Jody Wilson-Raybould to speak openly at the Justice Committee today, and I'm glad she had the chance to do so. I strongly maintain, as I have from the beginning, that I and my staff always acted appropriately and professionally. I therefore completely disagree with the former Attorney General's characterization of events. Our government will always focus on jobs and our economy. We, of course, had discussions about the potential loss of 9,000 jobs in communities across the country, including the possible impact on pensions. My job as Prime Minister has always been to stand up for Canadians and Canadian workers. I want to be absolutely clear here. The decision around SNC-Lavalin was Ms. Wilson-Raybould's and hers alone. I want to confirm this again for Canadians, as Ms. Wilson-Raybould herself confirmed today. This decision is the Attorney General's alone. Govern and make decisions for the good of all Canadians, we will always act within the bounds of what is appropriate. There is an officer in Parliament whose entire function is to look into questions of this nature. So I welcome the investigation by the Ethics Commissioner to clear the air on this matter, and it's important that we trust him to do his job. While this process continues, my steadfast focus will remain on Canadians and on governing in the best interests of people across this country.
Happy to take your questions.
Bonsoir, Monsieur Trudeau. Pierre Olivier.
Good evening.
Vous êtes en direct sur les ondes de LCN.
You're live on LCN network tonight.
Qui doivent croire les Canadiens aujourd'hui?
Who should Canadians believe today? Should they believe the PM, who's sworn for several weeks now that there was no political interference, that there was no inappropriate pressure? Or should they believe Jody Wilson-Raybould, former AG, who involved you very close and your entourage today? I continue to maintain, as I have since the beginning, that myself and my team have always acted appropriately and professionally. I absolutely do not agree with the former Attorney General's conclusions. And we have an ethics commissioner who is investigating this very question. And I support him in this and have faith in his results.
And
Andrew Scheer, the opposition leader, is demanding you resign, saying that you can no longer govern this nation in full conscience. And I know this is, I'm quoting him. What do you say to Mr. Scheer? Canadians will have a very simple and clear choice to make in several months between a Liberal Party that will always stand up for jobs and invest in our communities and create economic growth by investing in the middle class, and a party that is still the Stephen Harper party with his old ways of doing things, attack and divide and give the advantages to the richest to try to create economic growth, which never works. We will remain focused on Canadians to build a better world for them.
Catherine Kovacs de Radio Canada, Monsieur Trudeau,
Mr. Trudeau,
the accusation
of Wilson-Raybould towards you and interference from the PMO and the Privy Council are very serious. After all these accusations, does she still have a place in the Liberal caucus? Obviously, I haven't had a chance to hear her testimony in its entirety, and I will do that before I decide. If you were to do it again, in terms of how you manage this crisis, would you do the same again? We will always stand up to protect jobs, good jobs in Canada, and create others. And we will always defend our institutions and the rule of law in this country. This is what we've always done, and it's what we will always do.
Hi, Prime Minister. Vanessa Lee with CTV. The Conservatives are calling for your resignation, and we're wondering if you think you should resign and if you think anyone in the PMO or Cabinet should resign.
Canadians will have a very clear choice in a few months' time about who they want to be prime minister of this country and what party they want to form government in the general election coming up in a few months. There will be a clear choice to be made between the Liberal Party, this government that has always invested in Canadians, that has created record economic growth, record low unemployment, has consistently stood up for Canadian jobs, consistently defended Canadian jobs while defending our institutions and the independence of our judiciary. And on the other hand, there is a choice of the party that is still very much the party of Stephen Harper, that continues to attack, to divide, to play politics with big issues, and to consider that the best way to create economic growth is still to give advantages to the wealthiest. We disagree. That is why we have been working so hard over the past 3 years to invest in Canadians, to support Canadians, and we've succeeded in creating the economic growth that we've seen, and we will continue to do.
And can Jody Wilson-Raybould stay in the Liberal caucus, and will you allow her to run in the next federal election as a Liberal?
As you might imagine, I haven't yet had the opportunity to review her entire testimony. I will do that before making any further decisions.
Hi, Alison Northcott with CBC. Jody Wilson-Raybould referenced a specific meeting with you on September 17th. She talked about feeling pressure to give SNC a remediation agreement, and she says that you referenced the Quebec election and the fact that you were a Quebec MP. Is that version of events accurate?
My job as Prime Minister is to stand up for jobs right across the country, to make sure that we're creating good jobs, that we're growing more jobs, and that we're defending the jobs we already have. I have done that and will continue to do that right across the country. That is a fundamental role that Canadians expect of the Prime Minister, and it is something I will always do.
So, and how do you defend the conduct of your staff, given that she says what she experienced was completely inappropriate?
I strongly maintain, as I have from the beginning, that I and my staff always acted appropriately and professionally. And therefore, I completely disagree with the characterization of the former Attorney General about these events.
Chris Reynolds, Canadian Press. The Attorney General, former Attorney General, indicated in her testimony that there was information between the January shuffle and her resignation from cabinet that the Justice Committee would consider relevant. I'm curious why you didn't allow her to be free to tell that story.
Two of the fundamental pillars of both our justice system and our system of government are solicitor-client privilege and cabinet confidentiality. We consider that this issue before the Justice Committee and indeed before the Conflict of Interest and Ethics Commissioner is of such importance that we took the unprecedented step of waiving solicitor-client privilege and cabinet confidentiality to allow the former Attorney General to address this matter expansively and in detail. And that is exactly what she was able to do tonight.
Lastly, I'm curious if the interactions between the Privy Council clerk and Ms. Wilson-Raybould, if those were appropriate actions for the top civil servant to take with the cabinet minister?
The civil service in this country, which functions on a nonpartisan basis, is always focused on the best interests of Canadians, which also includes making sure we're standing up for jobs, protecting economic growth. That is something that the clerk and indeed all civil servants are very much focused on, and that is entirely what they do every day, which is focus on what is right for Canadians while defending our institutions. That is something that this government as a whole takes very seriously and always will. Merci beaucoup, tout le monde. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, everyone.